Kill the Messenger stars Jeremy Renner and is the true story of Gary Webb, who was a journalist during the 1990s and who uncovers the CIA's past role in importing huge amounts of cocaine into the US that was aggressively sold in the ghettos across the country to raise money for the Nicaraguan Contras rebel army. Despite enormous pressure not to release the story, Webb decided to report and released the evidence called Dark Alliance. As a result, he experienced a vicious smear campaign fueled by the CIA. At that point, Webb found himself defending his integrity, his family, and his job. Personally, I'm not big into political thrillers or political movies in general. They seem very boring to me because myself, I am not political at all and I don't pay attention to anything. And this is a story I did not know anything about, so I just went into it seeing another movie, liking Jeremy Renner and thinking it could be a fun movie to learn about some things, and I really actually enjoyed this film. It did a great job keeping me interested throughout the whole entire film. Like I said, I'm not into political films, but something about this film made me interested in wanting to know more about the story. It was interesting that the CIA was importing drugs into the US to sell money and get money for it, and something about that had me interested, and Jeremy Renner's performance in here was one of his best. His best performance for me is The Town, definitely, but here he plays Gary Webb, who had a decision not to publish this or go with the story and face a lot of things from the CIA and put his family at risk with everybody that he was interviewing. And he decided that this was something that needed to be brought to light and the world needed to see what was going on. And he definitely gave a best performance and delivered. This film definitely kept me interested. It had a great story. It was handled right. And not one scene I wasn't interested in. They handled it so well, and the information was, you know, given throughout the film at perfect moments. It had great pacing. There were times where this film was very suspenseful when he was being targeted and his family was being targeted as well, and you really don't know who was targeting him and the people he was interviewing and people stalking him, and the suspenseful moments definitely did deliver too. So I'm gonna go ahead and give Kill the Messenger a B+. This is Just Watches Movies, and I'll see y'all later. Bye.